the brutal Russian mercenary group Wagner, claiming it's performing educational activities in Belarus. The private military group, mostly made up of convicted criminals, registering as an educational organization in Belarus. This is neighboring Lithuania announces it is closing two of its six border crossings with Belarus, citing Wagner as a security risk. This is as in Ukraine, we have new video in out front, and this shows Ukrainian ground forces firing on Russian infantry vehicles, wiping them out in this particular case. This is as CNN is exclusively gaining the first access to the outskirts of a freshly liberated village where the possible use of U.S.-supplied cluster munitions helped decimate the Russian forces who left in defeat. Peyton Walsh is out front.
There may be ruin around them, but their direction is forwards. We're with the 35th Ukrainian Marines, the first reporters to get to the outskirts of Urozhenye. Yet another village announced liberated Wednesday. The victories may be small, but a constant.
So, just down here, Urozhenye. Yet another town taken as the counter-offensive does move forwards. We were just seeing the neighboring village taken last week, but they keep moving. With that much incoming, we're getting out of here as quick as we can while they control Urozhenye. The Russians do everything they can to make it a nightmare for the Ukrainians to be there.
The unit showed us the intense fight captured by drone. This, their tank advancing, dropping a string of anti-mine explosives behind it, they said, which then, once it turned, detonated. The unit released a video of them in the town Wednesday, of how they turned their firepower on what was once a Russian stronghold that shelled them. The company commander recalls many more Russians hidden there than he expected. Very many died, he says, especially when they started to run and when they held houses. Lots of them died there. But they were caught as they fled. The smoke around Russians, likely made by cluster munitions. Ukraine has said it is already using some rounds controversially supplied by the United States. We could not confirm if these fired here were the new American cluster bombs, but the losses suffered were clear. And they say their use is less of an ethical dilemma when you're in this brutal fight. I don't understand it, he says. That side is using whatever they want. Our people are dying from all this and it's okay. When the other side die, it's not. I don't understand. His footage shows how young some in the assault were. He has no time for Western analysts who say this should be moving faster. I would say they can always come to me as a guest and fight with me, he says. If someone believes that you can fly over the minefield on a broom like in Harry Potter, it doesn't happen in a real fight. If you don't understand that, you can sit in your armchair and eat your popcorn.
Yeah, you smell it.
Out here, the last month of advances feel both empty and grueling, littered now with Russian dead. They haven't moved perhaps as far as it has felt.
These just empty farm fields in which many have died to take each kilometer.
The Russians mined so hard here, they used this machine to do it. So much damage done, it's hard to imagine what plans Moscow had for here at all, had they kept it.
Aaron, just to give you some context here, about 10 days ago, we were with Ukrainian troops who had liberated Staromayorskie, that's the village across the river from where we were today, Urozhenye. But the problem they said they had was that Russians who were hiding out in Urozhenye were shelling them. Well, now the Ukrainians have moved forwards. They've taken that village. They've got rid of that problem. Look, this is village by village. It is slow, certainly, but you cannot doubt that there is progress. Aaron?
All right, Nick, thank you very much. And certainly slow village by village, but progress that we had not seen. And maybe the cluster munitions are really a determining factor right now. yet to be said for sure. I want to bring in Steve Hall, the former chief of Russia's operation for the CIA. So, Steve, look, this progress in the counteroffensive coming as the Wagner group seems to be massing in Belarus and has gone now and officially registered as an educational group there. It seems almost absurd, right? Why would we even be a need to even put such a charade out there? What do you think is going on?
It's kind of a question of what do you do with these guys, Aaron? I mean, you know, they have already shown themselves to be a threat to the Kremlin when they got halfway to Moscow under Prigozhin's control. So some sort of deal was cut. Now there's a bunch of them in Belarus, where the Poles, for one, have said, look, we're concerned that they're there. Now some of the other Baltic nations are saying, well, we need to, you know, close some of our border crossings because of their presence. So in that sense, that benefits Putin because he understands that there is still great Western political concern about some sort of greater war with Russia. And so if these guys are on the border with NATO countries, maybe bad accidents could happen. That plays into Putin's hands. But he can't forget about them either, because at one point it looked like they were coming for him. So even though they're in Belarus, they're still pretty close. He's got to keep an eye on them as well.
Right.
Where do you put these guys? I think Belarus is the only option.
I mean, it is sort of stunning, right? And I know that Lithuania, you mentioned other countries, Lithuania has said that because of this Wagner gathering that they're going to close several of their border crossings, with Belarus. What do you think? Is it a real risk that these forces could cross borders and do something?
You know, I think the threat of it, I'm not a military analyst, but I think the threat of it is probably greater than the actual, you know, tactical meaningfulness. I mean, I think if they attacked a NATO country, you know, it wouldn't be a big fight, but it would escalate things in a geopolitical fashion. And so that's how that benefits Putin. But, you know, realistically, do we think that they're going to, like, invade Poland? I don't think they'd be successful. I think the Ukrainians do have to pay a little bit of attention to them. They have to strengthen, you know, that flank that they have with Belarus, which, of course, takes their troops away from other options where they're needed in the south and the east. But in terms of an actual military threat, I'm not sure that they're that significant.
So I want to ask you about something that happened. We've learned that the Secretary of State, Antony Blinken, spoke today on the phone with Paul Whelan, an American who has been held in a Russian penal colony now for quite some time, 5 years in confinement altogether. So the fact that this conversation happened is significant. Whelan was able to speak directly to Antony Blinken. It does come, of course, as the Wall Street Journal is reporting, there's no evidence that Putin has any interest in hostage swaps right now or doing anything about the Wall Street Journal reporter, of course, who's also there imprisoned. Do you think there's progress being made at all right now?
You know, if there is, Aaron, it's going to be very, very, you know, closely held behind closed doors, which is how the Russians really, really prefer to do it. There's no good time to be a foreigner, especially an American or a Westerner, in a Russian jail. But now is a particularly bad time because really, aside from a couple of what I think are relatively small fish that we might have in American jails, these are some of these young hackers who might have been acting at the behest of the Russian government, who were extradited to the United States a year or two ago. Beside that, I don't know that there's really anybody left that the Russians are interested in. So it's really, it's not looking good for these guys, I don't think.
No. And of course, they used a lot in the Brittany Griner transaction for that swap as well. All right. Thank you very much, Steve. Good to speak.
Join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MACAD TV family. Please like and share MACAD TV. We love you all. Please support MACAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.